Hi, welcome back to English lesson. Today, we are going to learn about daily activities atau kegiatan sehari-hari. So, I want to ask you, what do you do every morning, every afternoon, and every evening? What do you do? Jadi, apa sih yang kalian biasa lakukan setiap pagi hari, di sore hari, atau di malam hari? So, do you watch TV in the morning? Or, do you play football in the afternoon with your friends? Or, do you read the book in the evening? Okay, we will discuss it later. So, now, have a look at these several daily activities. So, this is Nina eats noodle every day. Anna sleeps at 10 o'clock in the evening. Brian plays basketball every Friday. I study at 8 o'clock every morning. So remember, we can put every day, every morning, every afternoon, every evening, before or after the akhir kalimat at the end of the sentence. For example, John eats rice every day. Every day di sana. And I have breakfast every morning. Every morning, Lucas waters the plants every afternoon. Dan seterusnya, I watch TV every evening and I take a bath before sleeping. Okay, students, those are several examples of daily activities. So now let's try to make some sentences. Nah, di kalimat positif, if there is a subject, I, you, they, we, jangan ditambahkan s atau es di akhir kata kerja. Nah, kata kerja itu adalah verb, kata setelah subject. For example, I play football in the afternoon. Jadi di sana kata kerjanya play, tidak ada s. You walk to school every morning. Verbnya di sana adalah walk, tidak ada s. Nah, begitu seterusnya dengan subject they dan we. They swim every Tuesday and we study in the evening. Nah, jika subjeknya she atau dia cewek dan he dia cowok, kita harus menambahkan s atau es di akhir kata kerja. Contohnya, she reads a book every morning. Di sana tambahkan s setelah read. Nah, contoh kedua, he goes to the beach every morning. Jadi di sana ditambahkan es setelah kata kerja go. Nah, untuk kata kerja atau verb yang akhirnya o, sh, x, dan ss, itu harus ditambahkan es di akhir kata kerjanya. Seperti go menjadi goes, brush menjadi brushes, fix menjadi fixes, dan pass menjadi passes. Nah, penambahan S dan ES itu hanya berlaku di kalimat positif dan juga subjeknya she dan he. Nah, kita pindah ke kalimat negatif, subjeknya she atau he, tambahkan dengan does not dan verb. Contohnya, she doesn't eat noodle every day. John doesn't go to the beach every Sunday. Jadi, di sana ada kata does dan not, tinggal ditambahkan verbnya, yaitu eat dan go. Nah, kalimat negatif dengan subjek I, you, they, we, kita menggunakan do not. Tambahkan verb, contohnya, I do not play football every morning. You do not water the plants every day. They do not study in the afternoon. And we do not sleep in the morning. Nah, bagaimana dengan kalimat interrogatif atau kalimat tanya? Nah, jika subjeknya I, you, they, we, kita menggunakan do untuk membuat kalimat tanya, seperti do you eat rice every day? Or do they play football in the afternoon? Nah, jika subjeknya she dan he, kita menggunakan does. Contohnya, does Chika atau she study every morning? Does John atau he wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning? So, those are the examples of positive sentence, negative sentence, and interrogative sentence about your daily activities. So, do you understand now, students? Great, it's time to exercise. So, please do students' book, page 39, part 5 until 6, and also students' workbook, page 19 until 20. So, don't forget to photo the result and share it to your teacher. Thank you and good luck, students.